The competition in the market is quite intense right now, and this is mainly due to the fact that we have three platforms competing against each other. So we have a cable network that has the largest national footprint in terms of NGA coverage. They have merged with a mobile operator, which means that they are able to make four-play offers. And this is very important because they started putting lots of pressure on the incumbent that was forced to deploy fiber network. And finally, also Vodafone was pushed to invest in a fiber network. This means that you have right now three platforms competing on quadruple play, so they can offer convergence offers, let's say fixed and mobile offers. Portugal is a market that has essentially bundles, so 74% of the households have a bundle. So it's very important for these operators to be able to compete at these four-play offers. And what is also important is that you can see that there was a co-investment agreement between the incumbent, the former incumbent that used to be Portugal Telecom and now is new, and Vodafone. And this co-investment agreement is a very important and very interesting agreement because it's very innovative and allows both firms to share the fiber network in a more efficient way. I should say that we are quite unique in the fact that we have these three platforms competing. Usually, you have more competition when you have a cable network that puts pressure, competitive pressure, on the former incumbent. In our case, we have more than just the cable. We were able to have an impact also on Vodafone. And therefore, you have, in some regions, two fiber networks competing. In the majority of these areas, they are competing also with the cable network. And this is the area where it is quite unique, because this level of competition pressure that comes from the three platforms. In terms of Internet of Things and all this development and applications in cars, etc., the big challenge is on spectrum, on availability of spectrum, and of course on mobile networks as well. And in this sense, this means that we must be able to, on one side, to deal with releasing the spectrum that will be necessary for these investments. And on the other side, we must be able to have networks that will sustain the development of these new applications. However, I think that there are also some other challenges, like, for example, numbering. And for the machine-to-machine issues, for example, numbering will be a question because you need to identify the machines. The machines use SIM cards, so permanent roaming can also be a problem in the future. You know that according to the new European regulation, we'll have somehow in the future the elimination of roaming charges. However, we must deal with the issues that are relating to permanent roaming even outside the European Union. So I think that in the future regulators will have a lot of things to deal with. This is a problem for Portugal, it's also a problem for Europe, and probably this problem is even more serious in Europe. And in Portugal, I would say that the main areas of the country, more dense areas, so where you find the majority of population, they have already a large coverage of fast broadband networks. The problem are the rural areas and less dense populated areas. There we have done some what we call the rural networks investments with state aid. And this was mainly private-public partnerships agreements. And the question is that right now we have some areas that are covered with these rural networks, You have areas where you have lots of competition because you have several operators competing, but you might have these areas where nobody will have interest in investing. And this is the same for Europe in general. So the main challenge is how can you promote investment in these areas? I believe that in some areas, it's a question of time and operators will find some economic interest in investing in these areas, but some others will be a challenge. And in those areas, probably we will need more state aid in order to cover and to avoid the digital divide in these areas. In Europe, it's another issue because you have some countries where the current situation is less developed than the one that we have in Portugal. And therefore, there is a need of investment both at the private level, private sector level, and at the public sector level.